Well, there's a long history of research looking at the effects of cannabis in Parkinson's. Cannabis extract contains lots of chemicals, and most of the sort of directed research is focused on two main components, which is THC and cannabidiol. THC, or tetrahydrocannabinol, is the psychoactive compound, so that's the compound that will give you the high or the hallucinations, and obviously that's not a desired effect. And if you take THC in combination with cannabidiol, actually that reduces that effect of the cannabis to some extent. We've been quite interested in the past in looking at the effect of cannabis in Parkinson's. We did a study using an extract of THC and cannabidiol together in a capsule form to see whether there was any benefit for dyskinesia, and unfortunately didn't show that there was any benefit at all for dyskinesia. We asked patients whether they felt better in terms of other symptoms. There was a suggestion actually that cannabis extract, THC and cannabidiol together might be of benefit for sleep or pain, and those are aspects that we're hoping to explore more. There are also possible neuroprotective benefits of cannabis. In the lab work that we've done, we've looked particularly at THC and shown that it has protected nerve cells from dying in our cell culture model, and we're hoping to build on that in animal models. And it seems to work on particular pathways which we know are important in Parkinson's. So THC can rescue mitochondria, which are the engine houses of the cell, protect them from being damaged, and it also influences a pathway which is known as the PGC1-alpha pathway, which we know is important. The work that we've done to date has been in cell culture models. We need to replicate that work in animal models of Parkinson's, and so we're still a long way off from trialling it in the clinic, but it does show potential promise.